Mickey Harris joins us with a look at sports.
So Mickey, we've got a big game coming up next week against Middle Tennessee.
Yeah, we have a big football game, a midweek game, a Tuesday game. We're starting the week off with a football game. And we also have a soccer game that's going to be going on Friday, but we're going to get into sports right now. After struggling early in the season, the Trojan football team was looking for a way to get some wins. And after picking up their second straight victory on the road, it looks as if the Trojans have found what they were looking for. Taylor Burke has more.
Continuing on from their first win of the season, the Troy Trojans traveled to Arkansas State to battle with the Red Wolves. In the Sun Belt preseason polls, Troy was ranked number one and Arkansas State was ranked number two. And in the back and forth battle of one versus two, the Trojans were able to edge out the Red Wolves thanks to a Cornelius Williams touchdown that gave the Troy Trojans the 30-27 victory.
Well, it was huge and it could have gone either way. Arkansas State was well prepared. Steve Roberts, in my opinion, is a great football coach, and he's got this program ready to be championship caliber as it was in 05.
I mean, it was great. I mean, they was doing good all night, and then the big sacks came exactly when we needed them to, you know. And that's what happens. When you work hard every play, it'll come and good for you on the big plays.
It was a huge win for us. We needed it to start off in the conference 1-0 and had a great game. They played a great game, but we just outworked them.
The Trojan offense stepped up in a big way. After trailing 10-0 early on in the ballgame, Troy came back with 20 unanswered points before the back-and-forth battle ensued, with the Trojans making their final drive for the touchdown and the win. The Troy offense was led by quarterback Levi Brown, who had 355 passing yards for two touchdowns, while wide receiver Tiberius Gill had 10 catches for 85 yards and a touchdown.
It was great because we told the defense, just get a stop, we're going to score, and basically that's what we did. And they get the momentum to start, so we just continue to fight.
I think we're just a more well-rounded offense now. You know, it gives defenses something else to prepare for when they know that we can run the ball and pass the ball successfully. And then they got to defend when Dan goes in and we do all that wildcat formation. So, you know, we've got everything clicking right now.
Taylor Burke, Troy Trojan Vision Sports.
Troy returns home on Tuesday night to do battle with the Middle Tennessee State Blue Raiders in a game nationally televised on ESPN2. After defeating in-state rival South Alabama Monday night, the Trojan volleyball team will have some much-needed rest before they hit the court again. The Trojans only had one day to prepare for the match after playing two conference foes over the weekend. The Trojans defeated South Alabama in only three sets Monday night, but now their focus shifts to some conference competition on the road. They will travel to Arkansas Little Rock for their first conference road game of the season. Coach Sonny Kirkpatrick talks about how the Trojans are preparing for their road trip.
We've been studying a lot of tape. We've been working on some game plans. We've been just working on the things that we do and what we can capitalize on. And, you know, we're achieving our goals right now, and that's the big thing. If we keep playing at this level, I think we've got a nice season ahead of us.
The Battle of the Trojans will take place Friday night in Little Rock. The Trojan soccer team opened up conference play this weekend in Arkansas, taking on UALR and Arkansas State. Troy won the Battle of the Trojans Friday against Little Rock, Arkansas 2-0. Then the Trojans traveled north to Jonesboro to take on the Red Wolves of Arkansas State. The Trojans had never been beaten by the Wolves before, but the much-improved Red Wolves managed to upset the Trojans 3-0. Coach Chris Bentley on how the Trojans will be preparing for their next opponent.
I think it's important for us just to bring in intensity. I think more of it is a lot of just mental preparation for us. It's going to be a lot on the girls. But from a tactical point of view, we're going to continue to work on things with our forward runs being a little bit more dynamic in the attack.
The Trojans will be in action again Friday against Middle Tennessee at 3 p.m. at the Troy Soccer Complex. The Trojan rodeo team is gearing up for their second rodeo of the season Thursday. The Trojans had a good showing last weekend in their season opening rodeo in Missouri. The women's came in first place, scoring 325 points. Marla Seidelman finished first in the breakaway roping. The men finished in third place with 475 points. Clint Keller and Mark Gentry finished first in team roping with a time of 15.2 seconds. The Trojans will be on the road competing in the Southern Arkansas Rodeo in Magnolia, Arkansas. Well, Jessica, Meg, as you can see, we have a lot of Trojan sports going on. We're doing very well in conference play at this point. And the rodeo team are hitting the road again for their second rodeo of the season already. The football team is gearing up for the Battle of the Palladium, which will be a very good game on Tuesday night.
Yeah, I like how the rodeo team is going out to Arkansas when all the Trojans were in Arkansas last weekend. I guess they didn't get the memo, huh?
Arkansas is a very good place for us.
All right, well, thank you.